in fucking credible. Guess what, B? It's about to get incredible or rough. Incredible. So what did you say? You said the best song in the album was Cops Come Knocking?
I think Till the Cops is the best song on the album.
Okay. My favorite record on this album is Lonely is the Only Other Company.
Well, my favorite is Ascension.
Lonely, like, so. Lonely.
No, go ahead. Go ahead.
The title, right? So if you never listened to the album, if you didn't understand.
Mind you, still on the roof, by the way, with the fridge.
Still
the fridge.
On the
roof. With the fridge. All the way. With the fridge.
He's always.
Lonely. Always. Yo, bro.
But wait. If you didn't listen to the album, if uh-huh. you merely skimmed the track list,
right.
and you didn't understand the marvel of this pen up until this point,
right.
when you get to track 8, he's giving it to you in the title. Like, yo, you know what company I want? I want Lonely as my company. That means no one else.
No, bro.
Not you.
He is ruined at this point.
Yo, fam.
She ruined
Lonely,
him.
Lonely is the only other company.
She ruined him.
Was the craziest shit I had heard up until that point. Yeah. Like, up until April of 1996.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I had not heard anything that crazy in my life. Like, that shit spent me. And even as, I mean, we young adults, right? So we on our rap shit and we loving hip hop. But as we moving into... Right. grown up shit and yeah. romanticizing the R&B.
Yeah.
That record always stuck with me because as a writer and at that point strictly a rap writer, that was just an ill fucking concept. Like,
I mean, just literally it related to me. I mean, just being like a single dude, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, like no wife, no kids, you know what I'm saying? It's like you go through shit and whenever you go through shit, you gotta really like live with that on your own.
You gotta be by yourself.
And sometimes that loneliness is necessary. So he's but in this song, what he's talking about is like she ruined him, right? Like
right.
He expressed on whenever, whatever, right? He expressed that like, you know, what she did to him. He's begging for her to come back. Now he's just isolating by himself. And he's saying, like, not only does he want to be by himself, but even when he tries to go outside, like he tries to, you know, be in front of other people, he don't trust anybody's face. He says that.
Damn. Unless you're the love, no other love can be. I don't want these people around me. I don't want nobody else. I don't want nothing else.
He says I don't trust
another face. The only I've been having and sharing is lonely. That's it.
The woman dragged his heart and he still only trusts her.
Since you went away, I just look into other faces with no trust. Yo, fam, like, you ruined me. You broke. I can't even trust people. I got nothing. I got nothing for nobody else.
This shit is triggering right now.
So you don't want me to play this song?
Triggering, man.
Because I don't want you to have a moment.
We don't need to play this song.
We don't need to go. We don't need the song.
Thank you, Anna. Come on, man. Your vocal arrangements.
Since you went away.
Go ahead, bro. Stupid. Stupid.
Since you went away.
You hear the pain? You hear the pain?
And then he called the sax man.
In the background. Lonely. In the background.
Who plays sax? I want smoke with the sax man.
Oh.
The sax man came with the shit. Oh.
He came with it. He's like, you too? Don't you know? No. He's like, you too?
The sax man was going through some shit too, right?
You too?
Good.
Oh man, I think the people the I think the people on the zone.
I mean,
I think the people on the zone.
I'm the people, motherfucker. I'm the people. Viva incredible. That record's incredible. It's always been a favorite of mine. It's still a favorite of mine. It still evokes those same emotions that I fucking felt 25 years ago, but magnified. It's a hell of a record. It's a fucking 10.
It's a 10 piece. It's a 10 piece.
Yes. Yeah. What'd you like?
It's a 9.5 for me. Only because I tore my only critic, my only small criticism.
Didn't you just hear us cry? Didn't you just hear me cry with the sax, man?
I hear you, bro. I hear you. I've been there, all that. I'm just saying. The song itself, though, it kind of does the same thing for the entire record. There's really no, there's no change up at all. Like,
fam, no, that's not true.
And I'm, this sounds crazy because I hate criticizing the song because it's fucking great, but it's like a 9.7, but it's not a perfect song. Again, this song is perfect. I think whenever whatever is better. I think when the cops come, until the cops come knocking, is better. Slightly. So 9.5.
It's perfect. But I feel like, I'm not gonna debate shit 9.5, but
no, there's no debate. I don't have the bullets today.
Lord have mercy.
South of both. You know what I mean? I don't have the energy today.
Fam. I can't see them coming down my eyes, but I kinda make the soul cry. Like,
right.
That shit is amazing. That shit is amazing.
For sure.
Yeah, reunion is number 9. I'll let you take it back. I'll let you take it from there, B.
Such a wavy fucking track.
Super wavy,
man.
This whole album is a fucking
wave. This whole album's a vibe, but like, it's a very wavy joint. Because my point is, we go to like, he takes us to like these, you know, he takes us to that darkness, you know what I'm saying? And then,
couple times.
He enters her darkness.
Stuart is the sax man.
Yeah.
Come on, Stuart. Hold on, man. Round of applause. Round of fucking applause.
Stuart is the goat on the low, man.
Yo, fam, I might fucking rather do my next album with Stuart.
Stuart, yo, he's like the fake, like the John Bryan, like how
John
Bryan for Late Registration.
And John Bryan and that would do. I can't think of his name right now.
White guy?
Yeah. Fuck, can't think of his name. It's not important. We're talking about Maxwell. It'll come to me.
Okay.
Reunion. Back to the wave. I see waves all in the. I see wave emojis. Super
wavy.
In the comments.
Super wavy.
B, how did he get her back?
B, because he's Maxwell. You hear him all out? He was confident from the jump. Look. Jordan only scored the most points because he missed the most shots.
Come on with the, you know, I'm a sucker for a basketball analogy.
No, we know we suck for some basketball analogies, bro. You know what I'm saying? You fall 300 times, you got to get up 301 times. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what it is.
Absolutely. That's
what it is.
Yeah, man. Not too much to say about reunion. I mean, if there was any criticism, any at all, and it's really not, I just would be curious as to how we got from making the song cry to the reunion. Like, how'd y'all link back up? But maybe it was that vulnerability. Maybe it was that, like, yo, I can't do this without you. I need you back. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, Bonsu is the only other company.
That's my criticism. There should have been a song between this song.
We needed a song, to bring it together.
Because that nigga was about to kill himself. He's about to kill himself in the last song.
We skipped a step.
But I also love the fact that he used reunion and not anniversary, right? Like, it's our reunion. It's a celebration, our reunion. You know what I'm saying?
But they reunited.
Yeah, absolutely, man. You know that. Look, man, you get back with the right ex, man. That's a wave, man. You know.
Mhm. That's that. Mm-hmm. Where did reunion land for you?
Smart married man. Mhm.
Respectfully.
He's like, mm-hmm. I heard you. Heard you.
Yo, B, when you peep shit, you supposed to just peep it and shut the fuck up.
Yeah, yo, B, because I want to see this face right here. This right here.
It'd be the ones closest to you. I like to get you in partnership with, ladies and gentlemen.
I like to get you the
rap
out of school.
Where did you rate the song?
Now he's screaming on me.
Oh man.
I gave it an 8.5.
Yo, B, we are so in tune this album. I gave it an 8.5 as well.
It's the rims, man. It's the lids.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man. Damn, this album is so fucking good, bro.
So fucking good.
But let me is this a top 10 R&B album, and it is one of the top debut albums of all time?
Yeah, I think it's I've always had this album right under Brown Sugar.
You love Brown Sugar. Hated the D'Angelo verses, but loves Brown Sugar.
Hated D'Angelo verses because of Love Brown Sugar. it's one of those.
I set that up for you. I threw it up the bed.
And for the record, anybody who prefers this album over Brown Sugar, I have no problems with. It's a personal preference. There's nothing fucking really wrong with this album. You know, we're reaching for criticism with this album.
To fill up some content.
It's just gorgeous, man. The whole fucking vibe, man. The concept. He sticks to it. It's concise. I mean, besides it's like the little blip between Lonely's the Only and Reunion. Like,
right.
Yes, besides storytelling, like it's a fucking brilliant album. And if you really sit with what he's saying and how he does it and how he, how he approaches this woman, it's not cookie cutter. It's not Keith Sweat. You know what I mean?
That's what I said, at the top of this, nobody was, I mean, it was ballsy for a debut, but nobody was doing this, bro. Nobody was doing this. It wasn't what we were used to. It wasn't R&B that we heard before. It wasn't off the neo soul tree. You know, that's when I came with this. Yo, Maxwell is the male Sade.
He was
that's the only thing
Maxwell was his own genre, and I think he was a big part of, launching that. I think he was a big part of making neo soul really popular. That album is not really neo soul, but I feel like it's one of those albums that kind of sparked it. You know what I mean? Even Brown Sugar is not neo soul.
I keep making that distinction because I feel like people have put Maxwell, lumped him in with that group, feel like he is that.
That's my point. I think the Brown Sugars and the Urban Hang Suites, I think they actually launched the neo soul era along with Baduism, right? But these albums aren't neo soul albums. The Bilals and the NDREs and all those who came after them, those were very much neo soul. Mm-hmm. Even Jill Scott. But these albums are just fucking soul music.
This is beautiful. So you don't feel like Baduism is neo soul?
I do. I'm talking about two albums, Brown Sugar and Maxwell and Urban Hang Suite. I think they were part of the beginning of that renaissance, but those albums are just beautiful, contemporary soul music. They're new black music. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to my homegirl Tasha in the comment. She asked if he was a Kim.
Kim as well.
Kim predecessor. I like that. I like that question a lot. So Kim is if you're not in your R&B and soul bag, you might not be super familiar with Kim. I mean, we music people here, so I feel like this room is knowledgeable. But I do feel like I feel like without this, we wouldn't have been able to get a Kim. You know what I'm saying? Kim's his debut album.
The Kims, the Calvin Richardsons, you know what I'm saying? We can go on and on. I mean, I think Maxwell allowed these dudes to be themselves. Women as well, but the Guapolades, allowed them to be themselves, But this isn't a neo soul album. It's a fucking soul, it's a fucking brilliant soul record. And it's singular. You still don't have an album that sounds like this. You know what I'm saying? You have Alicia Keys, right, with her debut. So what's it, a song in A minor?
We having a nice time tonight, B.
I'm gonna back this car up right now. You're right.
We having a good time tonight.
I'm gonna back this car up, man.
Don't make me say something.
Yes, exactly. Also, yes, absolutely. Eric Robeson as well, man. Anyway, my point is, I feel like these albums allowed, because again, remember, black R&B singers before this, early 90s. It's The Man We Won't Speak Of. It's Jodeci. You know what I'm saying? Right. It's a lot of either begging, lying, it's just straight, it's beautiful R&B, but it's truly much the same. Or it's either they're begging it and begging to be taken back or begging for pussy, or it's fucking gospel shit. You know what I'm saying?
Or it's derived from hip hop. You know what I'm saying? It's that blend of,
hip hop soul,
R&B. Maxwell wasn't giving it. None of this shit. You can't rap on none of this shit. I mean, I can, but you can't rap on none of this shit. This is not what it's for.
Right.
You know what I mean? This is not a hybrid genre. Nah. This is not trying to.
There's no room for rappers on this.
There's no. A fucking 16 was laid, I'm shooting at you.
Burning the studio down. I'm burning the studio.
I'm shooting at you and people you love.
Right.
No women, no kids. But don't come in here with this spitting and skitting shit. It's not the time for that.
Nah, baby.
Sidebar, did you know that fucking Kenny Lattimore was with Faith, Judge Faith Jenkins?
Did not.
How he pull that off? Jesus Christ.
Nah. Kenny doesn't stand. Kenny's on the stand.
Yeah.
Even his joints are always. Kenny's on the stand.
Clearly.
And
wait, while we're on the subject, because now I'm just being messy and shit.
Okay, go ahead.
Is Halle Berry with Van Hunt?
Absolutely, my nigga.
Yo, what is this?
I didn't think it'll be out. I feel like I missed the free Apple phone sale, man. Like,
it was giving out phones. No, they were just giving Teslas away. Bro.
Just giving out Teslas. Like, I missed that. Word? Van Hunt? Okay.
Yo, Van Hunt's debut is criminally slept on as well.
Van Hunt's debut is tough.
It's criminally tough. Slept on. Tough. Not talked about.
Not good enough to get Halle Berry though. But cool, it's a good album.
This is what I'm hearing. You saying the word that I want to say. All right. Let's round this album out and get into Suitelady, the proposal.
We back with the wave. He's back. He's got confidence.
We back with the wave. We back with the wave.
He's back. He's back. He got his swag back. He got his woman back. This is the proposal. He gets the sweet.
So he learned the error of his ways, right? He learned. He got it back. He's not playing games this time around.
Got humbled.
Let's do this thing.
Yeah.
Let's do this thing.
Let's stop playing.
The proposal jam. Yeah,
my legs are tired. I've been chasing you. I was cocky. I got humbled. I was preferring lonely because you're not there. I've been at the bottom. If you're back in my life now, I realize there is nothing more important than you. You're back. Marry me.
I mean, it's a wavy joint. It's a wavy joint. It's a vibe. We back on the dance floor. We feeling good.
I also love, again, being a wordsmith. He's a writer. He used the word asunder in the hook.
Because why wouldn't he?
No one can tear asunder.
Let no man put asunder, right? He, like, taking that and putting it in that, and even the way he flipped Suitelady to make it phonetically different, yeah, for the spelling, made it a proposal jam. Like, it's, again, it's brilliant.